Opponents of a proposed budget cut for the Hinds County Sheriffs Department will meet again in Jackson tomorrow. The Board of Supervisors, you might recall, voted to slash that budget by millions of dollars. 60 WAPD's Aaron Kelly is live outside the Sheriffs Department with the latest on this controversial story. Aaron.
Good evening, Scott. Earlier this evening, religious leaders gathered outside the Sheriff's Department to oppose a $2.5 million budget cut. Strangely enough, the sheriff was here, but he wasn't talking, letting the pastors do the talking for him.
Change your vote.
Yeah.
Change your vote.
Yeah.
Change your vote.
Religious leaders making their case for the Hinds County Board of Supervisors Sunday. They want to turn back a $2 million budget cut for the Sheriff's Department.
And when we cut public safety, the public gets cut.
That's right.
Last week, supervisors voted 3-2 to trim the budget in favor of giving a $100 a month raise to county employees. Protesters claim that money should be spent elsewhere.
We need protection. We're here for public safety. So that's why the pastors have gathered together to come as one voice to encourage the Board of Supervisors to not cut that budget.
Supervisor Kenneth Stokes says the county has to put $1 million into a reserve fund. He also says the county doesn't need to fund more officers for Jackson.
Show me the crime that's taking place out here in the country. The crime is basically in Jackson. They got more police officers in Jackson than they have highway patrolmen. Jackson can handle Jackson.
Opponents of the plan say the sheriff's department needs more money, not budget cuts. The jail is in need of serious repairs after a riot and prisoner escapes this year.
We'll get the understanding that there will be a safety issue, then they won't come to this county. New businesses will not come to this county.
Sheriff Lewis was at the event, but would not talk to us about it. A spokesperson wouldn't give us a reason. He would only say the sheriff will talk Monday. As supervisors Stokes and Fisher have both said that under the current plan, the jail would be fully funded, but there is some disagreement about that. Also, a lot of numbers being tossed around this evening about potential layoffs, anywhere from 90 to 120. Scott?
All right, thanks a lot, Aaron. Quick question, though. What's next in this battle?
9 a.m. tomorrow, people are going to be back here outside the Board of Supervisors. Robert Graham, one of the supervisors, is going to be working with other people to try to get this vote changed. Scott?
All right. Aaron Kelly reporting live for us tonight.